we wake, hear the birds and see the sun. Side by side, our fears are done. Oh, the good times just begun. Oh, we know what we have, let's hold on tight. Found what we're looking for in life. Call us crazy, but things are finally right. With you and I, the future is bright.
So we purchased two types of seats because we weren't really certain what was going to work best. And this double seat situation seems like it's probably going to be the best because this is very similar to how the original manufacturer's seats were. They folded out into a kind of a day bed. And so kind of our primary thought, but we picked up these other seats that they sell at Cabela's and Bass Pro Shops and that kind of stuff because they're super comfortable and not very expensive, and wanted to see how that might work. But the benefit of these folding seats is that you can fold them right up to access the hatch underneath, and also, potentially, you can fold them into a day bed. And so that was kind of the hope. But fortunately, the shape of the boat is, it's just, there's no way to get these darn things to lay flat. So I don't know. It's not really looking like a very good option. So these seats do fit pretty well, and they do look decent, but they're not very comfortable. And yeah, so we're not totally sold on that. And then the gray seats, we couldn't find them that style in anything, you know, any better color than that. And it doesn't really match the boat. And, you know, it is convenient how easily they could be folded up. That's nice. But really, they're not, they are more comfortable than the other seats, but we're still not really sold on either. We're going to think about this and figure out what's going to be the best option. So I'm up here on the roof of our boat on the flybridge. And as we've been trying to figure out which seats we want to put up here, we ran across one job which we absolutely have to do before we put the seats on. And I'll show you what that is. For some reason, at some point in the past, somebody cut the front of these seat pedestals. And my best guess is perhaps I figured it was the only way they could bolt the seats on here when they put new seats on here the last time they did it. Well, I was able to remove the seats just by coming under the storage hatch here. Reach my arms down there and I was able to get the seats off. I would think you could put them on the same way, so it doesn't really make sense to me why they cut it, but we need to fix this because, especially on this one, you know, you can see I can move this pretty easily. It's not nearly as strong. Now, the thing hasn't busted yet in all the years it's been sat on, so we're not going to be setting out to make this joint, you know, extra strong, but just strengthen it up a little bit will be plenty. And thank goodness, because I think to do a real serious job we need to get to both sides of this, and I'm not about to try to figure out how to do that. So we're going to do a little fiberglass work, strengthen this up just enough that we don't have to worry about it and that it looks nicer. Then we'll get it painted up and looking like it should. So I'll film this as I go. I didn't film the grinding process. I did get my 4-inch grinder and I put a sanding pad on that. I made a big mess, but it did work really well to shave down. Someone had tried to repair this with some sort of a putty, which is still stuck in the cracks here. I'm not thinking I'm gonna mess with that too much. It's, you know, we'll just bond what we have back together here. I think this, not a fiberglass expert, but we're not trying to do anything extra strong here, and you're not going to even see this once the seats are on it. So anyway, yes, I did grind it down. Now I'm going to get it cleaned up real good, and we're going to start doing a little work on this. ¶¶ All right, so we're doing real good on this so far. I just came in with the little sander and some coarse sandpaper and knocked off the sharp edges on this just to already it's getting very strong, so yeah, I like that. So I'm in my Tyvek suit today, not because we're doing anything too major on the boat, but we'd love to be repainting it, but summer's coming and we're not ready to spend that many hours sanding in the heat, but we are going to do a little bit of touch up and repair on the boat until we do get around to painting the whole thing. And so I'm going to be sanding down the tips here. I already sanded previously a little bit right here and did some fiberglass repair, but we're going to sand these all the way down and really get them finished out nicely. Do a little bit of work right here on the front. There's a couple of the spots right down where we've probably hit a rock on a beach that I can work on. The other tip over here on the other leading edge. A few places up on the flybridge. We're just going to touch up a few of the areas that really are in need of attention. So we're going to get them sanded down, then we'll get some fiberglass repair work going on. So that's what we're up to. That's why I'm in my Tyvek suit. And you can watch and follow along. So I've just kind of hosed things off and cleaned up all the dust so we could see the state of things and looking at the front edge of the boat. And I'm very happy with the what's under all this paint. I mean, really, the fiberglass, it was almost all superficial. The fiberglass is just a few little spots where it's got a little damage. It's, you can see some filler right there. But really, everywhere I sanded down, it was mostly just damage to the paint. So there's just a few little nicks here and there. The most damaged spot's the same on both sides. And I don't know why that is. Right there is the spot where if you're trying to put this boat on the trailer and you miss, this is where you would impact the uprights. And so the other side is the same. Now I'm responsible for this because when I first tried to trailer the boat, the uprights weren't even, the padding was all worn off, and I hit it perfectly right here. And this spot had been filled, so what I knocked out was a bunch of filler. Now I've come since, I've actually already come in here and put a couple layers of fiberglass, new glass, and I'm gonna do that on both sides. I'm gonna come back in here and I'm going to just add a couple more layers of glass. So this is before I put any kind of filler in here. I'm gonna make sure it's that spot is the strongest spot because that is the point that takes the most impact if you have an accident trailering. But here's the other side, and you can see it's fiberglass is pretty solid all the way up. So yeah, and all the way down, just these, you know, there's a little filler in here, but all in all, I'm not too disappointed. I was worried we might uncover some, you know, more major damage from the past, but we didn't, so that's nice. So I don't need to bore you with painting on more layers of fiberglass. I've shot a lot of video of that, but I did just add a new layer of fiberglass all along the leading edge of this part of the boat. And there already was some filler in here, so what I did was put a layer of fiberglass over some of that old filler and kind of bonded it back into the original fiberglass of the boat. So I'm no expert on this. That may not be the best way to do it, but that's the way I did it. So on this side, I added another layer of fiberglass to the biggest damaged portion here. The rest of it, really, there's some old filler in a few places, but really it's in pretty nice shape. I didn't have any major problems with it as far as adding a new layer of glass. So after this, I think I'm gonna go to actual fiberglass filler, which has little bits of fiberglass in it, so it's still pretty strong stuff, and will any remaining little dents or gouges, we will go it with filler. So, and the same with the leading edge, center leading edge of the boat. Everything on there, to me, there's nothing I see needs glass, so I'm just gonna put a little filler in a few little places. So I've been, while I had my sanding disc out, decided to do some sanding on the very top edge of the flybridge, because there's so many cracks in these spider webbing cracks in the top of the flybridge, which we see actually in a lot of places in the fiberglass on the boat. What's interesting is trying to determine if they went into the actual fiberglass was cracking or just the finish, and it took a lot of sanding already to get down to even start to see some fiberglass. There appears to just be a ton of fairing compound on this. And so, assuming that these cracks are actually in the fiberglass, then we need to haul them out with a Dremel tool and fill them. So it's hard to even tell for sure exactly how much of the cracking's in the fairing and how much is in the fiberglass. So I'm gonna hit it with another round of sanding before we make a decision on what the final solution is. But I think we're gonna come over this with a fiberglass filled fairing compound and kind of rebuild it after we sand it. I'm going to update on my progress on the front edge of the boat here. There's the one big gouge on this side, and I did put some of that fiberglass filler in here. What I realized as I was doing it, I realized that it's just, for me, the gouge is a little deeper than I want to just completely put filler in. I wanted some strength. And the nice thing with this fiberglass filler is you can put fiberglass over it, and so I've added a couple actual layers of glass in over the resin. Of course, it looks kind of horrid, but this can all be sanded down. So we're still, as you can see, not got a smooth situation going here. But I like the fact that I put a couple more layers of glass in here, wrapped it around over that filler. Now, I probably still will use some filler to get the correct curve here, but hopefully we'll get some extra strength in that. So so some little strips and sheets of glass there. Also, I working on the front of the boat, and we got a lot to talk about down here. There's a couple injuries down here. I thought about just doing filler. I changed my mind. I've added a couple layers of glass right down in here. So on both sides and down through that. So now this one over here has that filler, and I'm feeling pretty good about that. We'll sand that and see where we're at. But that scrape there, you can still see the scrape, so we might need one more round, but it's looking pretty good. I know we can do that. So so we got that. Now, while we're looking here, you're gonna see the center line of the boat. You could see all the way down to fiberglass, and you can see bottom paint over various previous layers. You can see the original white that the boat was painted. It didn't originally come with bottom paint. It was painted white. You can see that original white. And what I found is all down the bottom, it looks just at the center of the boat. I mean, up here, it's not bad at all. But down here at the center of the boat, it's just cracking and chipping and fiberglass showing, even where I haven't sanded it, which I've sanded some of this, but what I'm doing now, I realize it's like that all the way down the bottom of the boat. So I am getting the 4-inch grinder with the 60 grit sanding pad, and I am sanding down the entire center of the boat under the trailer. As crazy that sounds, but I've already started sanding down there. You can see how much smoother that's looking down that way. Further down there, I have actually done some sanding. So sanding off everything that's chipped, everything that is not smooth, that has little stress cracks in it like that. Sanded all that stuff down. I've got one more round of sanding to go right here at the front and down at the very back of the boat. And then we'll come over that with, well, you know, fix this kind of stuff. We'll come over it with fairing and fresh paint, and then we'll talk about doing new bottom paint on the whole boat. So first things first, fix all that kind of stuff. The rest of this, we'll probably sand this down, but there's no major injuries and there's no major chips. You know, it's much less of an issue than right down here along the center bottom of the boat. So that's where we're at.
This side's nice all the way down.
So we're inspecting the boat and found that underneath the boat, which obviously needs some major repair here.
Just break this right off.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, legit.
You're gonna go back till you can't break it off, right?
Yeah, I'm gonna take all of it off. This patching material they use is not very good. It's not fiberglass.
Yeah.
But in general, the top of this could use just a coat over the whole thing. So there's, no matter how much we have left,
maybe we should do it in the morning when it's not so windy.
As long as it doesn't dry. Well, we'll do it in the morning too. As long as it doesn't dry, if we have any of this, if we still have some, we'll just smear it on the top there. Because we need to get more of a crown to this, because I sanded it all off. So. Start mixing, you move fast. I know I need to get these holes. The good news is you can sand this off. We're gonna be painting everything, so it's not that big of a deal if you make a mess with it. In this case.
You just got it all over the fender.
Oh, good job.
Can't sand my fender.
Nope, can't sand the fender. Alright, so it's thick stuff, but we can fill these holes. There's from an old cover that was on this. Job, we used it before it dried.
It's already looking better right there.
That's a miracle. That's a success.
It went on so good in the middle right there.
Well,
just don't get any on the gauges there.
Yeah, probably could have covered that, huh?
Yeah, I probably should have.
Got too much confidence in my skill to not spill. Drying already.
Mm-hmm.
Dang it. Too slow, I think. Yep, that's how fast it dries.
Jeez.
Yep, so I thought I would be smart and fix a lot. This dry air, it's...
the Arizona sky.
Yep.
dry as a bone. It'd
be better to have humidity and lower temperature. A little progress update on the front edge of the boat. We are getting so close. After the last fill of this polyglass, I've sanded it down now to get it kind of close to the final shape. And this is where the real bad spot was, and as you can see, geez, now it's really hard to even see anything. But I, using a bendy straight edge, I can kind of get a sense of a couple little spots that I want to touch up. And kind of the same thing on the other side, if not even a little more noticeable. This one's looking a little rougher, a little more obvious, you know, waves in it, but still pretty much the same process. So we're just going to mix up a tiny bit more, just fit a little more filler in those, because I don't want any, I want everything on these front edges to be solid as can be. I don't want to put any, I want to put only fiberglass filler in here. I don't want to put any just fairing compound over that. That fairing doesn't have any strength to it. So yeah, we're going to do all fiberglass filler on this, and then we'll get the shape just the way we like it. Then we'll put fairing over it to give it a nice finish. So there it is, just smeared on the last little layer. I don't care if it's got a few little tails, I can sand that right off. I'd just make sure it's packed on there nice and tight and all the way on both sides. And that's, just to me, that looks like it's absolutely perfect. And then this side, same thing. They say with this little mixing board that you can, when it dries, just twist it and it breaks and everything falls off. So I thought I'd give it a shot, but it's, I don't know.
Twist it and it breaks?
Yeah, it's flexible, and when and all the stuff just, you just twist the board around and then all the stuff.
Oh, it doesn't actually break, it just breaks the stuff on it.
Yeah, everything on it is rigid and just comes off. So I'm going to try that again. It didn't work with the fiberglass stuff, of course, but it might work with fairing.
Well, we'll see.
I'm not sure I'm doing a very good situation here. Seems kind of messy and ridiculous.
By the time we're done, we'll get a good system going.
Yeah, exactly.
That's what I thought. Small one would be good.
But
small
what?
Small paddle.
Oh, well, for this job, a big one. If that leading edge is rough, because
yeah, we can sand it.
Yeah, and we want it built out of nice and even, so it's fine.
God, it looks so much better.
I know, it's amazing.
So good.
So, yeah, as advertised, flexing this does nothing for fairing or fiberglass or any of this stuff. Completely.
You should tell them what it was meant to do, because you didn't tell them that yet.
I did. I did yesterday. I don't think I was filming that. Well, this thing is advertised.
that when you mix on it, you just bend it up and then whatever's on it will crack and fall off. Well,
it was a lie.
It's anything you put on it doesn't just come off. But I think it's still clean enough to use this time though. Because I cleaned it real well first.
Now I do want to show you the progress on the underside here. We had a nice gouge and you could still see the kind of the outline of the repair at this point. And I layered several layers of fiberglass in there to fill that. And what I've done now is I put the first coat of fairing over it and you know start leveling it out.
Okay.
All right, so test run here. Need to make sure these wood blocks hit at the points where the seat is going to hit. Can you see? Oh, that's beautiful. Okay, so I think we're going to probably settle on 2 inches of elevation on the chair. Because with the armrest down, it still just touches, but it's not binding up against the boat anymore. And then we're gonna see if we get away with sliding the seat inboard a little more since the steering wheel is, I mean, to be centered on the steering wheel, you gotta be sitting way off the side of the chair. So we can give it probably an inch and probably still have room to walk between. We're gonna bring the other seat up here and see.
We're test fitting our boat seats.
Yeah, and that's gonna be awesome back to back.
When we do eventually get 4 of them, we're going to put them like this. But for now, it's just going to be 2 forward-facing ones there. But that is going to look friggin' awesome.
Oh, and it's super comfortable. This is excellent.
That's really cool.
I like the armrests on here. It's going to be awesome.
Yeah. That makes me want to shell out the extra dough for the
seats, huh?
Back seats.
These are going to be mounted on...
Oh yeah, I forgot that. That's going to be mounted on
like this, so you can fold them up like this to get to everything.
And we're going
to
have a hydraulic spring in there, so I don't have to hold the seat up while I'm accessing my fenders. It's going to look awesome.
Yeah, they're just big enough, just the right size to fit.
We're almost ready for paint on the flybridge. It's going to be so good. Hey there. We are, as you can see, he's prepping for paint, which I'm super excited about, and we're gonna get started on that. But we're supposed to do it with temperatures less than 90, so we got up real early and it's still really hot. I'm a little concerned about that, but it should be okay.
What's going on?
Just painting.
Sun is in the wrong place to see this. But what you can see looks real nice. I want to show you the progress of the flybridge where the seats are going to mount. This is the first coat of paint on our fiberglass repair. And you can see, well, we're gonna do another coat of paint, but you can see just, it's just pretty flawless. And I told you when I started, I wasn't really going for flawless because it's gonna have a seat over it, but geez, I can't complain. So we've done a first coat of paint on the whole flybridge. Yeah, it needs more work, but it is amazing the difference already. We did get a few little runs, but this first coat's gonna get a light sanding in the second coat, and we're gonna be real careful not to do any more runs. and get it looking real good.
Feel your side.
I think the other side's smoother. I mean, not that this is shabby in any way, this is brilliant.
That's real smooth, babe.
I know. It's perfect, huh?
You did a real good job. It's real strong.
See.
Did you sand the middle?
No. The middle needs a little more fine tuning.
This is where that big old gouge was taken out. You literally can't even tell.
You can tell by the color.
Yeah. I mean, this is clearly where the gouge was, because this is where most of the glass and fairing and
yeah. You can see the actual glass I put in there, and this is the polyglass.
Yeah.
That fills in the gaps. But then
you can see the fairing on top of it. But this is literally so smooth, and you can't, like, there's no depression here. Yeah. It's so good.
It's amazing.
And once we paint that, nobody's ever gonna tell that we ran into our own
trailer.
Trailer.
Well, someone else ran into it previously because the old repair just fell out when we hit the trailer.
Yeah. So it wasn't all us, but it was kind of us.
Yeah, we. Yeah, it's real bad when you go down here.
When you say we, do you mean you?
Yeah, it's true. I was driving. But you were with me.
I was with you, but I wasn't driving it.
That was our very first time ever trying to put a boat on the trailer.
We were actually sea trialing at Lake Pleasant.
Yeah, very first sea trial, very first trailer.
Very first sea trial.
And wham!
Wham!
Right into the steel, which had no cushion.
Wham, bam, thank you, ma'am.
Yep.
And there it went. He actually still has the chunk that came out of it.
Yeah, it was previously filled. And I had that chunk somewhere.
Yeah. Now anyways.
It's properly filled.
It's real good. Good job, babe.
Thanks.
How do you feel about painting your boat on your birthday?
Oh, that's a great thing to do on your birthday. Well, I mean, it depends where you're painting at. This painting, easy. Laying on my back with my head an inch from the bottom of the boat, that's going to be the part not as fun.